clutch. Let's see. Oh, we should mark those. All right, we got our brand new clutch. Tool, a new pilot bearing. New throwout bearing, but that's already on the new slave cylinder. Alright, let's see if we can get this out without making a humongous mess. So far I haven't been doing good today at not making a mess. Burnt out my injector pulse tool because it touched ground when I wasn't paying attention and it fried it, so I need a new OTC fuel injector pulser. Yeah, let's get this all opened up. There's a brand new disc. Nice shiny brand new disc. And our brand spanking new pressure plate. Very nice. Let's go get some brake cleaner so we can degrease these surfaces. One thing I noticed about this flywheel, it doesn't have a drain in it. I'm used to seeing these with one single hole in them, just to drain out any crap that gets built up in them. All right, now take the new. Now, make sure when you put this on, sometimes they'll label you which side's the flywheel, which side's the pressure plate. But if you were to put this on with these facing in, they would end up hitting your bolts. So you want to make sure you're facing outward. And then the pressure plate, which I still have to clean off yet. It's the camera, folks. The camera gets you kind of distracted. We're also really close to putting this engine back in, so I'm getting a little bit anxious. But I don't want to rush and make any mistakes, like burning out my injector pulser. Alright, now we take this, set it on here, and this weird little tool that's in here for aligning the clutch. There's a Ziploc baggie and tape the baggie. Good job. Alright. Take this, put it in through the middle, so we can hold the disc in place. And then we'll take, or we can do it this way actually. Take the disc, put the disc against the clutch, or the flywheel, take your installation tool. Got to go right into the bearing in the middle. This is where the fight with the transmission comes in, because getting this bearing started in the middle right there is the hardest part when lining up the transmission. All right, so that's done. We got a guide hole right there and right here. So we're going to set these here, here, and here this way. slide it right over your installation tool and get it onto your first pin, which I'm trying to do right here. There we go. And get it up onto your second pin. There. Check it, line up with the bottom pin. Yep. Okay, now we got to run a couple of bolts in by hand. Where did I just put those? I'm going to put in two bolts for now, just for the moment, so that we don't end up with any potential problems with something falling off on us. And of course the socket that I need is over here too. Take some red or blue thread locker. Figure out where I put that's over there now too. If they tell you you're not supposed to reuse these bolts, well, it is what it is. One drop of blue thread locker. Next bolt, blue thread locker. Thread locker. Okay, now we're going to take the top bolt and the bottom bolt back out and apply some blue thread lock to these as well. And last one on the bottom. Thread locker. Now we're going to turn around and tighten all of these up in an alternating pattern. Now, probably be a very good idea before cranking these down tight. Make sure that things are loose enough. Center this. Move this up and down fairly easily now. Just press straight in on it. Make sure that it's as centered as you can get it. And then tighten down one bolt. And then go to the other side and snug up. Check everything, equal spaces, top and bottom. There we go. You're kind of anal about it. And then start alternating bolts. Get them all snug back up finger tight first. keeping all of these gaps about equal. Now these are all supposed to be tightened down to 15 foot-pounds and then an additional 45 degrees. They're going to go here, one more click, right there, to just a hair below level. Right there, let's see. From here to right about here. Peel away. Nice and slow, so not leave anything behind. Now, because there is paint on this head, I'm going to come back and I'm going to clean these back down again with some brake cleaner. Coming out pretty clean. I may have already cleaned this and forgot. Probably did in order to get the tape to stick. Alright. Now let's get this up in place, get these end bolts started. Now I'll set this right about here, and we'll get that bolt there started. That works. And same thing over here. Get our first bolt started. These are also 89 inch pounds. Alrighty. There we go. Got the intake bolted up. Alright, now I'll try to get this thing turned around. That way there we can get it ready to move to the other room. Put back in vehicle. Well, we're going to turn this around, we're going to fill it with oil. Now let's get some oil into this thing, start getting this thing primed. stump, so I'll hold it down. Oil filter off of this, maybe. Maybe, maybe not. Wow. Seriously? Just for ha-has, I'm going to get some comments for this. This is definitely going to be a comment trigger. That's kind of weird. This one here is not hopping as much as the other ones. But that's neat, because that's demonstrating there's compression in there, which is good.
Yeah, it's pushing it up.
But yeah, let's get that intake manifold back on it.
socket. Socket wrench.
Which is basically a twist of a wrist. These are the bolts right in here that everybody has the hardest time with.
Yeah.
But you have to take this off to get to the bolts underneath here.
Great design, right?
Oh, just lovely. Be careful, because I got a jumping cable right there.
Yeah.
Where are you? I just lost it. There it is. Trying to find that little bolt in there, and I can't see it. There it is.
Gotta go lay fuel on it?
Yeah. Then I tighten that up. Apparently not. Check, snug. Purposes, with the exception of the dipstick tube, I think it's ready to go back in.